Hey, what's going on, traders? So in today's video, I'll be talking about expectations. Are you having the wrong expectations about trading? Okay, now having the right expectations about trading is very important, right? Because if, let's say you expect to make a 1000% return in a month, okay, that's not realistic. And if you don't achieve it, then you're going to get disappointed and you're going to quit, okay? On the other hand, if you have the right expectation that, you know, you might not make money for your first 3 years of trading, right? And, you know, you just keep going at it, even though you are losing small money, right? You come in with the mindset of learning, right? And you go through the learning curve, right? You will be able to pull through the difficult period because your expectations is correct. Okay, I mean, think of it this way, right? Trading is a zero-sum game, okay? What does zero-sum game mean? It means that for you to make money, someone else must lose money, okay? So think about it this way. You are a new trader. You have 2 months of experience under you. You do not have a big account. You do not have experience. You never traded before. What do you think are your chances of winning compared to, for example, myself, right? Let's say you and I go on the sparring one-on-one match in trading, right? I've over 15 years experience. I've traded a very big account, right? What do you think is your chances of making money off me? Meaning that if let's say that you were to take a position and I take the opposite position from you, right? Because it's a zero-sum game. What do you think is your chance of winning? Probably very low, okay? But why is it that so many new traders, they come in with the mindset that, oh, I have 3 months experience. I've been trading 1 year. I have a $500 account. And they think that they can make money, right? It's just crazy. It's just, you know, I think it's just completely bullshit. I don't know why people think like that. If you are thinking like that, you need to stop, right? It's not being realistic, right? Just ask yourself this question, okay? You just have a couple of months of experience. What makes you think you can beat the big boys who have a lot of experience, a lot of money, a lot of resources to invest in algorithms, the smartest, you know, statistician to develop their trading strategy, right? What gives you an edge over them, right? So enough about the rant, okay? That's just a side rant that, you know, I've seen so many traders, you know, they say, oh, why can't I make money in my first 2 months, okay? It's just been ridiculous. Okay, so in today's video, I'm going to talk about how to set the right expectations in trading. Okay, specifically, I'm going to cover 3 pointers. Number one, are my targets realistic? Okay, let's say you have a trading target, you want to make X amount of pips in X amount of days. Is it realistic? Okay, how do you know if the target you set is realistic or not realistic, right? And if it's not realistic, what should you do instead? Like what's a reasonable expectation? Okay. So if you're new to my channel, right, you're new, right, I do a lot of videos like this. I like to use indicators. I like to use statistics to guide your thinking, right, because when you use statistics, you are being objective, okay? You're not influenced much by emotions. And in today's video, I'm going to talk to you about how to use the ATR, okay, average true range indicator, to set your expectations. Okay, now if you are new, you do not know what ATR is, okay, I have a video about what ATR is, but the short summary of what ATR is that ATR stands for average true range, and it measures the range of the entire candle, in this case 14 previous candles, the range, and you just kind of average it out. So for the past 14 days, the average movement from high to low for euro dollar, 74 pips. Okay, that's how you read it. Okay, so how do you know if your targets is realistic? Okay, now we're on a day chart. That means that you will expect the euro dollar to go about 74 pips, either up or down. Okay, so if you are expecting to make 200 pips in a day trading euro dollar, right, it's chances are it's not very realistic because the maximum range is 74 pips, right? So let's assume that you are a great trader, okay? You are a great trader and you got in at the absolute low for today, okay? Let me show you. Let's say this is today's candle and you got in at the absolute low, which is here, okay? Even if you got in at that best price, you're probably going to expect to make 74 pips, okay? 74 pips for today, okay? So that's how you kind of gauge whether is your target realistic, okay? If every day price just carry on to go, let's say just up, okay, let's just talk about it hypothetically. It just keeps going up, okay? So if you have a weekly target of 200 pips, then roughly you know that, okay, in the best case scenario, it probably take me about 3 days, assuming I just trade one position and I just hold on to the trade, it'll take me 3 days to hit a 200 pips target. Okay, I will not expect to make a 150 pips in a day from one position. Okay, of course, if you trade in and out, in and out, in and out, then that's a different scenario. But today, I'm just going to assume that you are trading just one position, right? You just take a, you know, just one position you hold. Okay, so if you use this ATR in this way, then you can kind of manage your expectation and say that, okay, the best case scenario is that I'm going to be up 74 pips for today. Okay, so if you are being unrealistic, let's say right now you do not have a very realistic expectation and you know you're making a you want to make 200 pips in a day from a single trade like euro dollar, right? Then you definitely want to go over to this indicator and use it to manage your expectations. Okay, so that's how you use the ATR to manage your expectation. It's pretty straightforward. Okay, now before I end off, right, I just want to end off with by saying that it's very important to come into trading with the long-term mindset. Okay, the only way you're going to be profitable is if you develop experience, and experience is a function of time, right, as well as losing money. Okay, if you come in and say I want to make money within 2 weeks, 2 months, you will not last, you will lose money. Okay, as I said earlier on, right, it's, trading is a zero-sum game. Okay, how do you expect to win my money, right, for me when I have a bigger account than you, I have more experience, okay, I've seen the market more and I've been doing this for well over 15 years, right? How do you think you can take the money from me when I'm more experienced, okay? I don't say this to belittle you, but I'm just trying to encourage you to have the right mindset, okay? If not, you're going to blow your account, and it's the fastest way to, you know, get into a lot of heartaches, right? Because you just do not have the right expectation. So take it slow, okay? Do your best to learn. Okay, come in with the mindset that, okay, for the next 3 years, 5 years, I won't expect to make money. And that's also the reason why you should be trading a small account, right? Like a $500 account if possible. Keep it small, right? When you're new, you're learning, try to lose as little as possible. Okay, but do risk real money because the feeling is different. If you're using a demo account, there is no real money on the line. There are no emotions. Okay, but in a live trading account, even a small one like $200, $500, that's where you face your demons, right? Like your actual emotions, you know, your greed, your fear, and a whole other spectrum of emotions. Okay, so that's it for this video. If you are new to our channel, make sure you hit the subscribe button. I have a 3-day trading guide for you in which I will leave a link in the description. Just make sure you download it. Okay, if any questions, just leave a comment down below and I'll do my best to address it. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.